What's up, you guys? Nicola Maserati here. So if you guys haven't noticed, I've been doing a lot of After Effects tutorials in my more recent videos, and I'm really excited because today we're gonna be talking about Mocha. Mocha is a planar tracking and masking plugin included for free in After Effects. Mocha is a super powerful plugin that I feel like everybody should learn. Not only can you do tracking, but you can also do masking and rotoscoping. So today we're mainly gonna be talking about the tracking, but I will be doing future tutorials on rotoscoping and masking in Mocha. But before we get into it, let's run that intro. All right, guys, so like I said, today we're gonna be learning about Mocha's tracking feature in After Effects. Before we get into that, if you enjoy this kind of content and you wanna see more, please make sure you subscribe, hit like, and hit the bell notification so you can be notified every single time I upload a new video. The great thing about Mocha is you have all these possibilities. It's an incredibly powerful plugin. And with the tracking, you can accomplish the same kind of tracking as you can with After Effects' motion tracker, but Mocha can also do it more accurately and faster because it uses GPU acceleration. Now, Mocha is a planar tracker. You can also say that it's kind of a texture tracker. So usually when you're tracking points in After Effects, you're tracking individual pixels within the search area that you created. When you track using Mocha, you're tracking textures, planes, and contrast, which means that you can also track things that are out of focus and you'll still get a really great track. So we're gonna be using this clip of a tattoo artist and we're gonna be tracking text to his tattoo machine. So let's jump into After Effects. All right, so we are in After Effects right now. And as you can see, we have our clip here. I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna drag it to create a new composition. You can see we have this tattoo artist tattoo machine. So the first thing we're gonna do is make sure that our clip is selected. We're then gonna go to animation and down to track in Boris FX Mocha. When you click that, you're gonna see this big button here that says Mocha. I'm just gonna click that and it's gonna bring up the Mocha panel. So the main tool that we're gonna be using is this X-Spline tool. This is gonna be the main tool that you use for about 90% of the things that you do. Another thing that you should definitely know are some keyboard shortcuts. Those are Z and X. If you hold down Z and you click and drag with your mouse, you're gonna notice that it zooms in and out. If you hold down X and click and drag with your mouse, you're able to move around the clip. So I'm just gonna use the keyboard shortcut and I'm going to zoom in here. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm going to be tracking text to this guy's tattoo machine. And you can see kind of how it's moving and it kind of goes up and it comes right back down. So we're gonna be tracking that. And I'm actually just gonna start right from the beginning. Now, for example, the clip was starting here. I would start in a different place. I would start to where the area that you wanna track is most in focus. So I'm just gonna bring it right to the beginning here. We're gonna choose our X-Spline tool and I'm just gonna create a mask. As you can see, when we're using the X-Spline tool, it's super similar to the pen tool in Photoshop and in After Effects. Pen tool's pretty much everywhere. And I'm just gonna kind of create a rough mask here. It doesn't need to be anything super perfect because even if the mask falls off a little bit, it's not a big deal because mainly we're just trying to get the motion. We're not actually tracking anything to this specific surface. So once you've made all the points that you wanna make, you're just gonna right click and there we go. From here, you're just gonna hit this track forward tool and we're gonna let it do its magic. And you can see it's sticking really well to the surface there. Now it may fall off a bit. So it fell off a bit when he went back, but that's okay. Cause again, we're still tracking, we're just tracking the motion. So you can see it fell off, but that's not really not a big deal. We're still getting all of that tracking information that we want. So you can see, if I just zoom out a little bit here, we can see the whole clip. If I just go through here, got that motion really nice. It fell off a little bit, which isn't a big deal. And then it came back. All good, not a big deal. So from here, you're gonna wanna go to the save button. This is save the project. Make sure you do this every single time. I've forgotten to do this. Luckily, there is a thing here. If you forget to actually hit that button and you hit X, there is a little thing here that's like, are you sure? Do you really wanna back out without saving? So that's kind of a fail safe when you're doing it. So I'm just gonna hit cancel there. We're gonna go up here and we're gonna hit save the project. And now we can just exit out. So from here, we're gonna create a new null object. So just right click, go to new. Go to null object. So we have our null object. You can see it just here. So basically with a null object, you can think of it as an invisible thing that holds data. That's probably the best way to think about it. So from there, we're gonna make sure our tattoo artist clip is selected, and we're gonna go down to tracking data. Here, the first thing we wanna do is hit create track data, and this is the layer that was created within Mocha, so we're gonna click that and hit okay. We're gonna go down to our export option, and you can see here we have a few different options: corner pin supports motion blur, and transform. For this, we're gonna be using transform. Corner pin is more if you want to attach an image, let's say, to a phone, or you wanna attach it to a poster and the camera's moving past a, you know, a poster or a billboard or something along those lines, you would use corner pin. I would do the one that's corner pin support motion blur, but we'll be talking about that in future videos for sure. But for here, you just wanna go down to transform. You're then gonna go to layer export to, and that's gonna be our null. And then we have these options here. You just wanna make sure that you keep it on source. Where they're gonna hit apply export, and you're gonna see the null move. And there we go, it moves right to our tattoo machine. So from here, we're gonna right click, we're gonna go to new, and we're gonna go to text, and we're gonna create some new text here. So I'm just gonna type in ink life. It can be whatever you want. I'm just doing this for an example here. We're gonna scoot this over here. So from here, we wanna go to our text layer, and we wanna go to parent and link. Click that and parent that to the null. So now you can see it's moving, and we'll just play it through here. And there you have it. Now the reason it's kind of turning like that is because we have the rotation on. So if we go to our null and we click down and then we go to transform within the null, we can just get rid of this rotation keyframe. And now it shouldn't do that. So you can see within Mocha, if we go back to Mocha here, you can see that we had transform, scale, rotate, and skew. So it created keyframes for each one of those. Mainly we want scale and position. If you didn't want scale, meaning when the tattoo machine goes back here and out of focus, it gets smaller, you don't have to have that. It can stay the same size every time. All you gotta do is uncheck this keyframe for scale, and now it'll stay the same size even when he goes back. So it's completely up to you on how you want to do that. I'm going to hit Control Z here because I kind of like that it goes back. But yeah, the text is perfectly tracked to his tattoo machine. And yeah, that's pretty much the intro to tracking in Mocha After Effects. All right, guys, that is it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you got something from it. If you did, please make sure you hit the like button down below. Make sure you subscribe, and I'd love to hear what you think of this in the comments. Yeah, guys, I'll see you in the next video.